number one. That can unite us.
Number two, that can unite us, actually, is you come to the issue of language. Something we did, we were visiting Norway with the late chairman of the Experiment in Tokyo. I think that was in 2002. Now, there was a meeting. We was rather like this. We want to talk because we was to talk to the socialist there. You see, people started identifying themselves. Somebody who can talk Arabic, that means he's from there. From the Sudan, by that time, we were also there. Yes! So, we now in the South, like if you go to Kenya, if you are a true Kenyan, you must not show him. That is an impact. You go to Tanzania, and you are a true Tanzanian, you must speak Swahili, and so on. So it is important for us at the level of the South to begin to devise some language which can bring us to a lingua franca. And we are beginning to propose some Arabian saying that why don't we develop the Arabic accompaniment? Ah, of course! They go for our business to do that. That can really bring us together. But at the same time, we must continue to promote our respective, what we call ethical or community language. Yes. This must be developed in that state, every state. This is important. So that we give our law Africanism, the custom. Our identity. So if you don't know your language, please don't make your kids in the house only to speak English, as if you are going to be English, don't you have more math? Please teach your language. And then let them also know some Arabic. Because you are going to lead the people. You cannot be promoting your own without English. You are already South Sudan in people. So it is important. The issue of language can unite us. So we must begin to plan for commonality, common language. This is absolutely important. Then we have number three, the issue of curriculum of education. Curriculum of education. Do you know why in the South there is a lot of tribalism now? Because the education system is not like in our land. In our time, do you know, we, because of the Europeans here, right from elementary, even intermediate, you will be moved from your place far away to go and do your intermediate very far away. In another community, somebody will move from Newbury to Accra. You can see Accra is where. Another one will move from Ren to go to Loha, secondary school. I moved from my village there, south of Cuba, in Loha, all the way to go and do my intermediate in town. Yes, when we are still here. And then you begin to see people from other times, when we are still here. And you begin to be friends with these people. Yes, rather than waiting, you finish your elementary, you see you are right. You are secondary school, you see you are right, you don't see other times. You go to the university, it is now some mistakes that are not going to the university. Also, you see you are right. Then, if you use to give a reply, you may not know other times. Then, there's a surprising thing when you don't go and meet this new person from a different time. Where? In the office. Into the pussy, we're going to be. But then you begin learning, like when I was in front, those of you who know Tom well, but who knows Tom very well. We have friends. We go deep. There is the village of Sultan Maya Alco. He said it was my close friend. So we go there for 3 weeks. We go and drink milk. And then also, they did the request of life at the community's head. So then we respect also other communities. They are asked their way of life, very important. And you respect them also. So there, you know, in my village, we don't have cows. Our cows were looted by the Mahadev. First, the terrorists came in 1859. They took the cattle, the Mahadev came, and also took their bodies, and the rest were killed by tetanus flies. So I grew without knowing how to live. Now, when I went to my quarter village, my friend, early in the morning, he went, said, well, let us go and drink milk. Then we went to go and to the stable to go and drink milk. Now, we started drinking one cup. He said, well, we yours. He said, I'm going to drink. I said, I don't know how to drink. He said, he was very stupid. You are big like this. You don't know how to drink. I said, I don't know. He could not drink. Then, because we are friends, another year now, he was telling me we were going to my village there, in the local communities. And we were not looking in the garden and so on, and we saw cassava. And then he said, ah, what kind of tree is this? And then I recall our situation of Pankota, said, you will be shocking. I said, you will be stupid, he is a tree. But the generation of this year, we are afraid. They lead our country to great generation. Because they are big, they don't know themselves completely. Even only knows this small village. This is very bad. So this, we will have to improve on this. Number four is freedom of movement. Movement. Freedom of movement. Of course, there's nothing that movement. The whole area, if my area in Lobano is 10,000, then we move to Pankoro, then all the 10,000. No, this is not the people, this is the people of the person. But as an individual, we can, for example, organize our chiefs to go and see other places.